Assalamu alaikum students, a very good morning to you all. Today we'll be completing the remaining part of drug metabolism and biotransformation. I saw your yesterday's assignments and I was really happy, and I'm glad you all understood the topic. So let's continue. Yesterday we did the phase 1 reactions of biotransformation, and today we'll be doing the phase 2 reactions. So phase 1 reactions were oxidation, reduction and hydrolysis. Phase 2 reactions are basically the conjugation reactions. These are also known as the synthetic reactions. What happens in conjugation reaction? There is addition of an endogenous ionized molecule to the original drug or to its phase 1 metabolite. Phase 2 reaction may also occur directly. Usually it follows the phase 1 reaction. If the phase 1 metabolites are still not very ionized, they will undergo a phase 2 reaction, which is a conjugation reaction. It is also known as a coupling reaction. So there are some endogenous substances in our body which are ionized. They will bind to the metabolite and will make it more and more ionized and water soluble to make it more excretable, which was the main function of biotransformation, the aim of biotransformation. So these conjugates are polar molecules that are readily excreted and are often inactive. And the conjugate formation involves high energy intermediates and specific transfer enzymes. So yesterday we discussed that after the phase 1 reaction, the metabolites could be active, inactive or toxic. But after the phase 2 reaction, the end product is usually inactive. So you can see here, a lipophilic drug, what we have to do, we have to make it water soluble. This is the aim of biotransformation, right? So a lipophilic drug, first it enters phase 1 or undergoes phase 1 reaction, which is oxidation, reduction and hydrolysis. And following phase 1, the drug may be activated, inactivated or unchanged. Then if it is still not very excretable or not very ionized, it will enter into a phase 2 reaction, which is a conjugation reaction, and conjugation products are formed which are always water soluble and they are usually inactive. But there are some drugs which directly enter into the phase 2 reaction of biotransformation. These are the different types of phase 2 reactions. You have to memorize them all with the three examples for each reaction. These are glucuronidation, acetylation, glutathione conjugation, glycine conjugation, sulfation and methylation. Aapko reaction type ke naam se pata lag sakta hai ki iske saath kaun sa endogenous substance jo hai wo involve hoga isme. Like in glucuronidation, this is the most common type of phase 2 reaction. Glucuronide group, acetylation, acetyl, glutathione, glycine, sulfate and methyl groups. These are the endogenous substances. So, abhi humne peeche baat ki ke enzymes are involved in these reactions too. So, the enzymes for glucuronidation, they are microsomal enzymes and rest of them are cytosol and mitochondrial enzymes. These are the drugs which undergo phase 2 reactions, like acetaminophen, diazepam, digoxin ki glucuronidation hoti hai to make it more excretable. Isoniazid undergoes acetylation. Acetylation ka important point which you need to remember is that the acetylating ability of different persons varies. This is due to their pharmacogenetics. Some people are rapid acetylators and some are slow acetylators. Ethacrenic acid follows glutathione conjugation, and niacin, salicylic acid, glycine conjugation. Acetaminophen is paracetamol, Panadol. Sulfation or methylation hoti hai dopamine, epinephrine, histamine and norepinephrine ki. So these are the differences of phase 1 and phase 2 reactions. You can get such a question in exam. Phase 1 reactions are non-synthetic reactions. Phase 2 are synthetic reactions. These are coupling reactions. Phase 1 reaction involves oxidation, reduction, hydrolysis. Phase 2 involves conjugation reactions like glucuronidation, sulfation, methylation, acetylation, glycine, and glutathione conjugation. Phase 1 are mostly cytochrome P450 mediated. Phase 2 are not usually cytochrome P450 mediated. In phase 1, there is unmasking or insertion of a polar group to the parent drug. In phase 2, there is introduction of hydrophilic endogenous species. Phase 1, the drugs may be inactivated or activated, and in phase 2, the drugs are usually inactivated after the phase 2 reaction. And phase 2 reaction is relatively rapid acting as compared to the phase 1 reactions. Now let's discuss the factors affecting metabolism or biotransformation. You can get a question to enlist the factors, or you have to write a few lines about them. So the first factor which affects metabolism is age. Extremes of age affect metabolism, like in infants and old age, the metabolism is slow because the enzyme system is not completely developed in the kids. And in old age, there is decreased hepatic functioning, as we all know. That's why metabolism would be slow. Then there is sex. The sex differences in drug metabolism are under the influence of sex hormones. Most of the drugs are metabolized quickly in males as compared to females. The next important factor is genetics. There is individual variations in drug metabolism, which is under the genetic control. Like we discussed earlier, some are fast acetylators, some are slow acetylators. Acetylation of isoniazid is an example of genetic factors affecting metabolism. And like yesterday we discussed, succinylcholine is metabolized by pseudocholinesterase, and that enzyme is also under the genetic control. Then there is first pass effect. I want you to write down what is a first pass effect. Nutritional status also influences the metabolism. If a person is starving or he is malnourished, then metabolism would be decreased because of decreased amount of proteins. As we all know, enzymes are protein in nature, and glycine stores are also depleted in starvation, so glycine conjugation will also be altered. Then is pregnancy. Pregnancy alters hepatic drug metabolism. The metabolism of some drugs would be increased and of others would be decreased. It is also under hormonal control. Then are different pathological conditions like liver disease. Obviously, if a person is having a hepatic disease, we know the major site of metabolism was liver, so it would be decreased. Likewise, if a person is having a cardiac disease, the cardiac output would be low, and metabolism would also be decreased. The last point is drug interactions. If you are giving multiple drugs together at the same time, one drug would affect the metabolism of the other, and we'll be discussing it shortly. So these are the factors which will affect the metabolism of drug. So let's discuss the effects of drugs on metabolism. If multiple drugs are given together, one drug may increase or decrease the metabolism of the other. So first is enzyme induction, which means acceleration of the metabolism, increasing the number of enzymes. Induction means you are either increasing the synthesis of enzyme or decreasing the degradation. So there are some drugs which increase the synthesis of cytochrome P450 enzymes or decrease their degradation, thus increasing the overall number of enzymes available for metabolism. And this thing will speed up the metabolism of the drugs. Like you can see here, see the density of the enzymes. After enzyme induction, the density has increased. So the metabolic capacity of enzymes is increased, leading to rapid metabolism of drugs, and thus the drugs are becoming inactive earlier than expected time. So the required effect is observed for shorter duration. So what will happen after enzyme induction? the activity of the enzyme is increased, so the metabolism of the drug will be increased. The drug will be metabolized quickly. Its half-life will be decreased and it will be available for shorter time. So duration of action will also be decreased. The process is called enzyme induction and the drugs are called enzyme inducers. You are often asked to name the enzyme inducers in your exams, and this is a very good mnemonic to memorize it. CRAP, GPs, carbamazepine, rifampin, alcohol, phenytoin, griseofilvin and glucocorticoids, phenobarbital and sulfonylureas. Isko aise bhi yaad kar sakte ho ke most of the anti-epileptic drugs like carbamazepine, phenytoin, phenobarbital are enzyme inducers. Alcohol ka point yaad rakhna hai ke chronic alcoholism induces the cytochrome P450 enzyme and acute alcoholism inhibits it. So now what is enzyme inhibition? It is the depression, it causes the depression of metabolism. On repeated administration, cytochrome P450 is inhibited by decreased rate of synthesis or increased rate of degradation. So less enzyme is now available for metabolism. It is opposite of what we have studied in enzyme induction, right? So if you give a drug and it increases the rate of degradation of the enzymes or decreases their synthesis, it's gonna decrease the metabolism of the drugs. So the density of the enzymes is decreased after enzyme inhibition. The metabolic capacity of enzymes is decreased. Drugs become inactive after longer than the given time or expected time. So required effect is increased for longer duration. So if you give enzyme inducer, it's gonna shorten the duration of action of the drug. Half-life could decrease karega. And if you give enzyme inhibitor, it will prolong the duration of action of the drug because it is inhibiting its metabolism. Again, the examples, the drugs are called enzyme inhibitors and the mnemonic is sickfaces.com. Sodium valproate or valproic acid, this is anti-epileptic drug. The remaining of the anti-epileptic drugs, they were enzyme inducers. Isoniazid, cimetidine, ketoconazole, fluconazole, acute alcohol, chloramphenicol, erythromycin, sulfonamide, ciprofloxacin, omeprazole, metronidazole and monoamine oxidase inhibitors. So aap isko aise bhi yaad kar sakte ho ke majority of the antibiotics, they are enzyme inhibitors. So that's all for today. If you have any questions, you can ask in your WhatsApp group. And for assignment, you have to write down the phase 1 biotransformation reactions with one example for each reaction, phase 2 reactions with one example for each reaction, and tell me if drug A and drug B are given together and drug B is metabolized by cytochrome P450 enzymes and drug A is cytochrome P450 inducer, what will happen to the half-life and duration of action of drug B? And drug C and D are given together. D is metabolized by cytochrome P450 enzymes. Drug C is enzyme inhibitor. What will happen to the half-life and duration of action of drug D? Write down their answers and submit them in your WhatsApp group. Thank you. Take care. Allah Hafiz.